We will solve irodov problem 157. It's a chain problem. In this, a chain is hanging freely like this, tied to a thread and touching the lower part of the chain is just touching the table surface. This is the table surface. This thread is burnt, means the contact or the support is removed. Now what will happen? The chain will start falling down. And it will be like this. It will keep on falling. For doing the physics problems, especially the complicated ones, it is always advisable to just imagine little bit and draw the diagram. And in this case, the chain is falling and assembling here at the bottom. What we have to prove is that at any given moment when the chain is striking, the force exerted by it is equal to twice the force due to the chain which is already there on the table. In chain problem, it's always better to take length as x. Let us consider this length. At any point of time, length is x. What is the mass of this chain at any given point of time? Mass will be mass per unit length. Let us say that is lambda into x. And in such problems where chain is falling, or problems, chain problem or jet problem, suppose water jet is striking the wall, you have to take the rate of change of momentum when it is striking, and for that it is necessary we should know the rate of flow of mass. Please note, in chain problem or liquid problem where you can divide it into small parts and they are striking, there we should know the rate of flow of mass. Once we know this equation, we can know dm upon dt would be equal to lambda dx upon dt. This is nothing but velocity, so it is lambda v. V is the velocity at any instant where this distance is x and the initial height is, say, L0 is the length of chain and x is the distance of the chain which has fallen. Now what is the velocity at this point? Velocity at this point is equal to the energy gained because fall in height, and it's a case of a free falling body. In a free falling body, velocity is equal to root twice gh. So here the velocity would be equal to root twice g. H is how much? It is L minus L0 minus x under root. This is the velocity at any instant x. Now this velocity of chain is same for the whole part of the chain. So it means the mass which is striking the table also has this velocity. Once it strikes the table, it comes to rest. So the change in momentum is equal to, let this small part have the mass dm, v into dm. V is the velocity of this mass. So delta p upon delta t, you divide by this, delta t tending to 0 would be dp upon dt is equal to v times dm upon dt. V times dm upon dt. So what is your dm upon dt? So dm upon dt was lambda v. So rate of change of momentum would be equal to lambda v square. This is nothing but the force. So the force being exerted by each part when it is striking is equal to lambda v square, where v was twice g L0 minus x under root. So the force is twice g L0 minus x into lambda. This is the force. Now, what is the length which is already on the floor of the table? What is the weight because of that? Weight because of that would be also same length has assembled here. And what is this? This is L0 minus x lambda g is the weight of the length which is already there. And this is twice of this value. If you compare, this is twice of L0 minus s lambda g is 2 times. So the force exerted is twice the weight of the chain already on the table. So for chain problems also, always solve it like this. I'll just mention couple of other points related to the rate of change of momentum, especially when a jet strikes the wall. Let us take this case. A water cannon is striking the wall, and let the rate of flow of volume, means Q dot, be equal to say some value x. If you multiply this by rho, you get the rate of flow of mass. This is the mass which is flowing and striking. Let us take a small part of the cannon, length dx. Area cross section is A, and rho be the density. This is the mass of the small part of the cannon moving with a velocity v. It strikes and comes to rest. So this is the change in momentum. I can write dp divided by dt. Both the sides you get rho. This is nothing but again the velocity a, v is again the velocity. What is this? Rho v a is nothing but the rate of flow of mass, because the q dot is area into velocity. Area is the cross section area, and m dot was rho q dot is equal to rho a v. So this is m dot into v. So it is m dot into v again for the force. So in such problems, the force exerted is equal to rate of flow of mass into velocity is the force exerted. So such problems should be approached by this method. So that's all. Thank you.